Welcome to Neotal Empire Tutorials. My name is Carter, and I will be your narrator for this video. Today, we're going through the basics of Unreal Development Kit, or UDK, and everything you need to know to get started on game development. First, let's talk about the backstory, as I think it is important. So what is the Unreal Development Kit? The UDK is essentially Unreal Engine 3, but modified and tailored specifically for independent game developers, aka indie devs. Originally released in October 2009, it became one of the best engines for game developers to rely on. This has since changed as Unreal Engine 4 would succeed it, and now Unreal Engine 5 is in development and will soon succeed UE4 as well. As a result, UE3/UDK have been discontinued by Epic Games, meaning the download to the builds and the original forums have been shut down, with no way to recover them besides the Wayback Machine and any local backups someone may just happen to have luckily preserved previously. Not too good a situation. Fortunately, the UDK veterans are here to save history. You can join the Discord server to download any of the UDK builds you wish to use for game dev, along with some other gems, should you prefer to do so. The link to the server is both in the description of this video and the pinned comment. Now let's get started. The first thing you will want to do is download any engine build of the UDK. We will be using the February 2015 build for this tutorial video. We have also using the empty game project setup, but feel free to use the UT sample game project setup if you want. Just know that things may look and feel tricky moving forward with the beginner's tutorial series if you choose to use it. Now that you have the UDK installed, let's launch the Unreal front end. Here you'll see a lot of features necessary for UE3 game development: compiling scripts, cooking content, launching and packaging the game, and of course, the Unreal Editor, aka Unreal Ed. There is also the Unreal console for any special actions for the engine savvy folks if you need it, and I guess for whatever reason UDK decides to act the fool, you can press that reboot button. You will likely not need to use these last two very often, if at all. Now let's launch Unreal Ed. Here in the editor, we have two windows. The first one is the Content Browser. Here you can browse through content available for the game. Content is depicted as objects. They vary from static meshes, the static objects that help build the world, animation sets for animating skeletal meshes, usually characters, textures for giving our objects some graphics, materials for shading the world, usually using textures, particle systems for effects, sound cues for combined audio effects, and many more. If you want to import your own assets or create a new package, you can use the Import and New buttons, respectively, found on the bottom left of the window. The next tab is the Actor Classes. This tab allows you to select actor classes and place them into the viewport, or create archetypes via right-clicking them. We will explain more about that in future videos. The next tab is the Levels. This displays sublevels within the persistent master level. This is ideal for level streaming, but we will explain more about that in future videos. The next tab is the Scenes. Here you can view the data of all of the actors in your level, the actor name, tag, type, any layers they exist in, if applicable, any attachment base, if it has been attached to something, and Unreal Kismet data, location, and the package it belongs to. You can also filter actors to narrow your search for specific types via filter type, or search for a specific one by name using filter text. The next tab is the Layers. Here you can view the layer information of levels, assuming you have created any layers at all. The final tab is the Documentation. You can always view the UE3 documentation whenever you are lost and need help. I think it used to be more decorated than this, or at least that's what Onye Nacho told me, but I guess since the UDK website has been shut down, the HTML data no longer works. If you need more help, you can also visit the UDK Veterans Discord server for additional assistance. The second window we'll discuss is the viewport. As you can see, there are plenty of features to play with, but we won't go through all of them as some are more complex than is necessary for this tutorial. We're trying to start small here after all. First, we have the Builder Brush. That is the red wire box gizmo at the center front of your screen. You'll need this to build brushes in your scene. But there is one problem. You might assume that is a BSP cube brush created from the Builder Brush, but it's actually not. It's a static mesh. You see, this level is already pre-built, so it's hard to demonstrate the features. Let's move to a brand new level to demonstrate instead. Head to the top left of the editor, and click File drop-down, then New Level, then choose Blank Map Template. Now that we have a blank map, we can properly demonstrate our features. Ensure that the render mode is also set to unlit as well. Just look for this icon here and make sure it highlighted, typically in blue for a standard Windows operating system. If you want to switch your brush type, just click on any of these buttons over here to change your builder brush type. You can click this button to add a new brush into the scene. You can also click this button to subtract from brushes in the scene. Useful if you want to make interior corridor rooms inside brushes. Perhaps you'd like to shapeshift your brush for some reason instead of sticking to the basic shapes. Use these buttons to do it. They will intersect or de-intersect the brush respectively, based on how the brush is overlapping with other brushes. If you want to add a volume to the scene, use this button to add one by clicking on it and selecting the volume of choice from the drop-down list. If you ever lose your brush for whatever reason, just click on this button to move the camera towards it. Let's start another new level to showcase the render modes. Feel free to save this if you really want to. Same area as File, but instead you click Save Current Level and choose a directory to save to. Right now, we are currently on Lit Mode. This mode showcases lighting and shadows, the final result of the world after geometry, pathing, and lighting have been built. In Unlit Mode, the level is rendered without lighting or shadowing. In Wireframe Mode, the level is instead rendered in wireframe, showing off the polygons in full detail. There are other render modes, but they are more complex than this tutorial video is meant to cover, so we'll have to cover them in a future video. Over here are the gizmo tools. You can move, rotate, and scale actors in the scene with these. Here you can build geometry, lighting, and paths. Here you can edit the mobile previewer settings, test your level on mobile or PC mode, enable Kismet debugging, or test directly in the editor. Finally, over here, you can save your data, undo, redo, load an existing level, or start a new one. You can still, of course, do that through the File drop-down, but this is just a quicker way to do it if you prefer using that instead. That concludes this tutorial video. Hopefully, you now understand the basics of using the UDK to create content for your game. Next time, we will demonstrate how to make your first level and few tips and tricks on level design. Until then, this is Carter signing off.